blessing God tonight. I'm glad to have you here again. Amen.
And I won't turn back, cause I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I can't turn back, and I want to see my Jesus someday.
Thank you.
and I won't turn back. Cause I want to see my Jesus
Bible to Revelation 12. Page 608. I saw a new heaven and a new earth.
Revelation 21.
I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth were completely gone. There was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem. It was coming down out of the heaven from God. It was prepared like a bride, beautifully dressed up for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne. It said, now God makes his home with human beings. He will live with them. He will be his people. And God himself will be with them. This will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or sadness. There will be no more cry or pain. Things are no longer the way they used to be. He who was sitting on his throne said, I am making everything new. And he said, write this down, you can trust these words, that they are true. He said to me, I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. I'm the beginning and the end. Anybody who is thirsty may drink from the spring of the water of life. It doesn't cost anything. Those who overcome will reach all these for me. It will be their God, and they will be my children. But others will have their place in the lake of fire that burns with sulfur. Those who are afraid and those who do not believe will be their murderers, and those who pollute themselves will join them. Those who commit sexual sins and those who practice witchcraft will go there. Those who worship statues of God, all who tell lies, will be there too. It is the second death. One of the seven angels who had the seven poles came and spoke to me. The bowls were filled with seven last plagues. The angels said, I will show you the bride and the wife of the Lamb. Then he carried me away in a vision. The Spirit took me to a huge high mountain. He showed me Jerusalem, the holy city. It was coming down out of heaven from God. It shone with the glory of God. It gleamed like a very valuable jewel. It was like a jasper, as clear as crystal. 12. The city had a huge high wall with 12 gates. 12 angels were at the gate. One at each of the one. When the gates were written, the names of the 12 tribes of Israel. There were three gates on the east and three on the north. There were three gates on the south and three on the west. The wall of the city had 12 foundations written on them, were the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. The angel who talked with them had a gold measuring rod. He used to measure the city and its gates and its walls. The city was laid out like a square. It was as long as it was wide. The angel measured the city with a rod. It was 1,400 miles long. It was as wide and as high as it was long. He measured the wall of the city. It was 200 feet deep. The angel did the measuring as the human being would. The wall was made out of jasper. The city was made out of pure as glass. The foundation of the city walls were decorated with every kind of jewel. The first foundation was made out of emerald.
The first one was made out of jasper.
The first foundation was made out of jasper. The second was made out of sapphire.
Sapphire.
The third was made out of chalcedony. The fourth was made out of
emeralds.
The fifth was made out of sardonyx. The sixth was made out of carnelian. The seventh was made out of chalcedony. The eighth one made out of mirror. The ninth one made out of tonic. The tenth one made out of sardonyx. The 12th was made out of
jasper.
The 12th made out of amethyst. The 12 gates were made from 12 pearls. Each gate was made out of a single pearl. The main street of the city was made out of pure gold, as clear as glass. I didn't see a temple in the city. This was because of the lamb, the Lord God, who rules all our temple. The lamb, the city does not need the sun alone to shine on it. God's word is its light, and man is its lamp.
The nations
will
walk
by the light of the lamb, the kings of the world will bring their glory into it. The gate will never be shut, because there will be no night there. The glory and honor of the nation will be brought until only what is pure will enter it. No one who fools others are just same fool thing will enter it. Only those whose names are written in the Lamb Book of Life will enter the city. Amen.
Amen.
The presence of the Lord is here. open up the Bible, your Bible to verse.
Revelation 22.
Revelation 22. 16. Then the angel showed me the river was a water
of the water of life.
It was as clear as a crystal. It floated from the throne of God and the Lamb. It followed down the middle of the city main street. Its fruit was ripe every month. The tree rekindling of the nation.
To the nation.
There will be no longer any curse. The throne of God and the Lamb will be in the city. God's
servants
will serve him. Then will see him.
They will see
his face. His name will be on their forehead. There will be no more night. There will not be a night. Of the light of the sun, the Lord God will give the angels that
the Lord God will give them light. They will rule forever and ever. Number six.
Said to me, you can trust these words. They are true. The Lord is the God of the spirit of the three
prophets.
He sent his angel to show those who serve him are things that must soon may take place. Jesus is coming. Look, and I am coming soon. Blessed are those who obey the words of the
prophecy
in this book. John, am the one who heard and saw these things. After I had heard and seen them,
I fell to worship
at the feet of the angel. He is the one who has been showing me these things. But he said to me, don't do that. I serve just as you do.
God's servant. Sister Priscilla, we'll finish.
Verse 9. But he said to me, do that I serve God just as you do. I am God's servant, just like the other prophets, and will obey the word of this book. Worship God. Then he told me, do not seal up the words of the prophecy in this book. These things are about to happen. Let those who want to keep on doing wrong, let those who are doing wrong continue to be evil. Let those who do what right keep on doing what is right. Now let those who are holy continue to be evil. Look, I am coming soon. I bring my reward with you. I reward each of you for what you have done. I am the Alpha and Omega. I am the first and the last. I am the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who are washed their robe. They will have the right to come to the tree of life. They will be allowed to go through the gates of the city. Outside the city are the dogs who have practiced witchcraft. Outside are also sisters being murdered. Those who worship statues, everyone who loves and does what is false are outside too. I, Jesus, sent my angel to continue this witness from the churches. I am the root and the son of David. I am the bright morning star. The Holy Spirit and the pride say, come. Let those who hear me come. Anyone who is thirsty should come. Anyone who wants to take the free gift of the word of life should do so. I am warning everyone who hears the word of the prophecy of this book. If you add anything, God will add you to the plague told about in this book. If you take any words away from the gift of the prophecy, God will take away from your share of the tree of life. He will also take away your place in the holy city. This book tells about these things. He who is given to these things said, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. May the grace of God, Jesus, be with God's people. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Give myself away, so you can. My own. I give myself to you.
My life is nothing without you, God. I give myself to you. Nothing is as important as you, God. I give myself to you. Above everything in my life, I give myself to you. About everything that I want, I give myself to you. I give myself to you. For there's nothing as important as you are. Amen. Oh God, Heavenly Father, we thank you and we love you and we adore you and we give you praise and we give you the glory, Father, because you are God all by yourself. And you deserve the glory. You deserve the honor. You deserve the praise. Hallelujah, Father. Thank you, Lord, for giving us one more day, Lord, to worship and to praise your name, to come to your temple, to glorify your name, Lord. You didn't have to do it, Father. You didn't have to wake us up this morning. You didn't have to give us the chance, Lord, to even breathe, amen, one more breath this morning, amen. But because you are merciful and loving and gracious, God, amen, you favor us, amen, with so much blessing. You favor us with so much, hallelujah, Father, so we'll come back in here and praise your name. So we'll come back in here and glorify your name. So we'll come back in here and tell your people one more time that Jesus is coming. To tell your people one more time to beware, amen. To tell your people there one more time, and Lord, to get their orders straight, hallelujah. Oh, God Almighty, we glorify your name. We honor your name. And we marvel at your wonders, amen. Because you are wonderful and mighty. God, Father, we thank you one more time, amen, hallelujah. As we enter into our sermon, amen, hallelujah, let your word speak, hallelujah, Father. Let me not add one word, amen, and let me not take away one word, hallelujah, Father, because you are God all by yourself, and you are wonderful, mighty God. In Jesus' mighty name, we praise you, amen. Are you ready for Jesus? Are you ready for Jesus? Are you ready for the new coming of God? Sometimes we say sometimes that, hey, I want to see Jesus. I want to go see Jesus. I want to see Jesus. I want to be in heaven. I hear a lot of people say that a lot of time. I want to go see Jesus. Amen. I want to see his wonders. I want to see his palace. I want to go home. Amen. I want to go home. I want that wonderful homecoming feeling. When I'm in heaven with Jesus, amen. I want to go. I want to go home. Amen. But Jesus said, amen. Amen. In Revelation 21 and 22, that's what we're going to be preaching on today. My brother David and Sister Christina already read the verses for today for us, so we didn't have to take as long to go into our sermon. Amen. Jesus is coming. Amen. Blessed are those who obey the words of the Bible. Throughout your life, since you was infant, most of you read the Bible. You analyze it the way you want to analyze it. You claim out Jesus' love. You know that. Each time people say, oh, you gotta change your ways. But Jesus is love. Jesus is love. Yes. Jesus is love. Yes. God is love. Yes. But he also said, I am coming. I am coming for those who commit sexual sins. I'm coming for those who are lesbian, homosexuals. Amen? I'm coming for those who fornicate. I'm coming for those who do adultery. I'm coming for those who sleep with animals. I'm coming for those who lust. I'm coming for those who lies. Amen. Jesus is coming. But are you ready for his coming? Jesus is coming. But are you ready for him to come? That's what you gotta ask yourself. Amen. Ask yourself that. Are you ready for Jesus to come? Are you ready for the next step of your life? The second death. Are you ready for that second death?
Amen.
Because when Jesus comes, and your things is not in order, your life is not in order, you will be experiencing that second death. Right? Yeah. Going into the sulfur fire, right? You will be going into that second death. But others will have their place in a lake of fire that burns like sulfur. Amen? Verse 21, verse 8. Yes, Jesus is love. Yes, he loves you. He just can't stand your sins. Yes, he loves you. He wants to save you. He gives you descriptions of how heaven looks like. Amen? I want to be in that pearly gates. I want to see Jesus. I don't want to be outside that 200 feet of walls. The outside wall is 200 feet long. That's a lot of gate. And the inside is 1,400 miles long. That's the size of heaven. 1,400 miles long and 200 feet thick. That means nothing can drill into heaven. When you in there, you in there. Right? 12 gates for the 12 tribes. I want to see that golden gates, that pearly gates, that gold and amethyst and all that jewel. I want to see all that. I don't want to be outside looking in. I don't want to be like one of those dogs, he said, who's going to be outside looking in. Always being the outsider. Right? In life, you are an outsider. In heaven, you want to be an outsider too. You're watching everything going on from the outside. Right? We all blame our circumstances and say, well, I didn't raise up with a spoon. I didn't experience much. But this is the time for you to say, I want to experience Jesus. I want to experience God. I want to know him for myself. Right? The verse 15 and 22 says, outside the city are the dogs and those who practice witchcraft. The dogs, the one who didn't worship God. Right? The dogs, the one who said, I don't want Jesus. He can call us dogs at the end. He didn't call us his children, right? He called us the dogs. Are the dogs. We are the dogs. The one who refused to listen to and practice the word of God. The one who always said, God is love, so it's okay if I got that little K pride. It's okay for me to be a lesbian, gay, men and men can be married and raise a family, which is a condemnation in front of God. But hey, it's okay because I got that love, because God is love. He put love in my heart. But at the end, he called you a dog for refusing to obey his word. So therefore, I suggest you repent. Repent because God is coming. Repent because there is no time left. Repent. Amen? Repent. If you're still doing witchcraft, if you're still pouring on hexing spells on someone, I suggest you stop it. Because you're not going to go into the pearly gates. You're fooling yourselves. You're fooling yourselves. Right? You're fooling yourselves. Okay? Those who commit sexual sins, murderers, will never get into heaven. Murderers, if you take someone's life, you will never get into heaven. So I suggest you start praying. Amen. Murderers. Those who come in sexual worship statues. Amen. If you're giving your glory to another person, if you're giving your glory to an idol that you see, stop it. If you worship the statues of gods and everyone who loves, well, I'm still on verse 15. Everyone who loves and does what is false are outside too. So be careful on what you love. Yes, I love him. Oh, I love him. He's my life partner. We just got married. Everybody congratulating you. The minute somebody said no, you are doing wrong. The Bible said females and females that I get married, a man and a man that I get married. Oh, I love him because God is love. But if I say a woman who loves, of being going to heaven. So I suggest you rethink. Amen. You rethink what the Bible said. Amen. Everyone who like to hoard stuff, like say, I love this. Oh, that's my thing. You worship it. You like you say, well, I like this fucking chair right there. It's a nice chair. Don't touch it. Why you see that it's mine? I love it. It's mine. Everywhere you think about it, you love it. This is a nice lamp. I like this lamp. Don't touch my lamp. Because don't touch it. Don't touch. That's mine. I love this. You love it. You taking your time. I've got to go wash home and sit on my chair. Relax. That's mine. That's my love. You get up in the morning, you think about it. You wake up at night, you think about it. You go to sleep, think about it. Every single thing of your life, you think about it. You love it. You're obsessed with it. Did you know about loving that chair so much? A bit obsessed about it. You feel like this is yours. You like your possession. You hold on to it so tight. Maybe sometimes you need to let go. Material wealth, you need to let go. Don't be so in love with material possessions. Material possessions will keep you from going to heaven. Let go of it. Be a generous giver. Give it out. Give it all away. Anything that's keeping you from going to heaven, give it all away. I'm not going to hold on to anything that's hindering my chance of going to heaven. Right? I'm not going to blow my life away over something that's not important. Amen? So, I suggest you learn to listen. I suggest you live a godly life so you don't experience that second death. Amen? Those who worship statues of gods and all who tell lies will be there too. It is the second death. Those who tell lies. I know people say, I know someone said during the week, oh, I'm a good liar. I'm a professional liar. I'm a better liar than you. But guess what? If God had come during that time, you think you'd be going to heaven, or you'd be experiencing that second death? Right? Do you think you'd be going to heaven? Don't brag about being a liar. Don't lie until you become a professional liar. Right? Learn to tell the truth. Only those who practice the truth, who do not practice anything false, will be going to heaven. Right? I want to be one of those person who walk into the city walls The foundation of the city walls were decorated with every kind of jewels. I want to be there. I want to be inside that 1,400 mile long stretch wall. I want to be one of the people in there. 1,400 miles long, 1,400 miles wide, 1,400 and then tall, 1,400 miles tall. I want to be living there. You think I want to be living in my 1,300 square foot house? No! I want to live in a 1,400 mile house. I want that mansion. Like yesterday, me and my kids went to see the firework, and I was just staying there looking at all those beautiful houses by the lake. And my daughter said, oh, I want to live in that big house. Look at it. It's so big. Look at that light, that chandelier. Look at it. Oh, mommy, look at this house. I want a house just like that. It's so big. It's two stories. Lights everywhere. People was outside the house, sitting down the porch, just having a good time. They look like, man, they're living a good life. They got that money. My kids was like, wow, I want that. That's what I want to. I want to get one of those when I get bored. I said, I want to get that 1,400 mile house in heaven. I want to live on that 200, inside that 200 thick wall house instead of that little walls I got. That's so thin, man. My son could put his face in the wall. That shit white built house. That thick brick house. You know? I want to live in a house where when I walk in it, the floor doesn't shake. I want that solid foundation, right? I want that solid foundation. I want to have sunshine every day. I want to live where there's no more darkness, where there's no more pain, where there's no more misery, there's no more iniquities. I want to live in a land that is so blessed. I'm seeing angels everywhere. I want to live in a land where I don't have to get up in the morning to go to church because God is the church. I could be with him 24/7. I have to get up and go get dressed. Hurry up. Come on, kids. Hurry up. We got to get to church now. Come on now. We got to get there to open the door. Let's go. Let's go. That's what we got to do. I want to be where it's always church. 24/7. 7 days a week. Non-stop partying in heaven. Non-stop sunlight. I want to be in a church where the trees grow all day and night, and where the fruits are always ripe, mangoes. I want to be in a church where I could get me everything I need. And I want to be in glory with God. Amen. I want to be at the throne of God. I want to be right next to him. Amen. I want to be with him in heaven. Are you ready for Jesus to come? Are you ready for that second coming? If you are still doing idolatries, worshiping different statues, different gods, different trees, the trees, the land, you're worshiping anything that you hold on to, that you can't seem yourself to get rid of, and it become an idol, it become a god to you. Can you say, I'm going to clean out my house and just throw away things? I don't need it no more. Just throw it away. Don't let that thing be a god to you in your life. Don't hold on to something. Amen? Hold on to God. Hold on to God. Because like it or not, Jesus is coming. Like it or not, God is going to be here. Like it or not. You're going to be seeing Jesus one way or the other. Either you're going to see him and be glorified with him in heaven, or you're going to see him and be judged and go straight to hell. It's up to you what you decide. But as for me and my house, we will continue to serve the Lord. We will continue to worship and praise Him. We will continue to say, Jesus, you are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. You are the only one that we have to serve and worship. As for me and my house, we will continue to worship with God and know that hey, Jesus is coming soon. Jesus is coming soon. And verse 7 said, look, I am coming soon. Blessed are those who obey the words of the prophecy in this book. But there's so many people who say that this is just a book. This is just a book. It's not important. It was written by man. So therefore, it's not that important. I don't have to listen. Who really wrote this book? Did you know it was the king of Britain or whatever who wrote this long time ago? Everybody's dead. Who knows? They just made it up. There's people who keep us lying to themselves and try to convince people, but hey, this was just a book. But the book, but this book says, amen. The book says, blessed are those who obey the words of the prophecy of this book. Amen. So I suggest you learn to obey the word that's coming out of this book. I suggest you learn to take God's words and pour it. He said, do not seal up the words of the prophecy in this book. These things are about to happen. Let those who do wrong keep on doing wrong. You could tell somebody to repent so many times. You could tell somebody to do right so many times. But it's that person to decide, am I going to continue to do wrong? Like the book said in verse 11, Revelation 22, verse 11, let those who do wrong keep on doing wrong. Let those who do evil continue to do evil. Because their names already written in the book of death. They will be experiencing that sulfur fire. They will experience that second death. Amen? Because the Bible said, those who do wrong will never get into the kingdom of God. Your life must be as clear as water. The only way for your life to be as clear as water is for you to constantly repent. To constantly come into the presence of God and say, God, I'm sorry. I want to be saved. I want to go to heaven. I want to experience your love. I want to be there. Let those who do what is right keep on doing what is right. And let those who are holy continue to be holy. Okay? So obviously, if you want God bad enough and you know He is coming, you change your ways. Lord, I am coming. I am coming soon. He didn't say, oh, look. He put an explanation point. He said, look, I am coming soon. With two explanation points. Obviously, he's shouting at us to stop our bad ways. He said, look, stop it. I'm here, I'm coming. Do you want to live within the 1,400 mile high? You want to live that 1,400 mile stretch long house? You want to live inside that? Or do you want to suffer in that sulfur fire? You have to decide. I bring my rewards with me. I reward each of you for what you have done. I have the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, and the beginning and the end. I will reward each of you. I'd rather get rewards for being blessed. I'd rather get rewarded for doing what is right instead of being cursed and be sent to the second death. Be careful of what you do. Be careful of what you do. Blessed are those who wash their robes. Wash your robes. Wash your skin. This is your robe. Blessed are those who wash their robe. Blessed are those who keep their self holy. Who keep their spirit, their self holy. Who live according to the word of God. Who said, God said, don't, thou shalt not lie. And because he said, liars, what? Don't get to heaven. Right, Sister Christina? Right? Blessed are those who do that. Blessed are those who wash their robes. They will have the right to come to the tree of life. They'll be allowed to go through the gates into the city. They'll be allowed to go through the gates into the city, the 12 gates. So be careful of what you do, because God is coming. Wash your robe. Like the song said, whiter, sweeter, sweet, sweeter, sweeter, sweeter is Jesus. Wash away my sins. There's so many songs that talk about washing away of your sins. Right? Whiter than white. You want to be whiter than white. Because you got to be clear to enter the gate of heaven. You want to be whiter than white. You want to make sure your sexual immoralities, you stop doing it. You got to make sure you don't kill nobody because murderers don't go to heaven. Yes. You ask God for forgiveness. Yes. Murderers don't go to heaven. Okay? Learn to ask God for forgiveness. Okay? Everybody makes mistakes. But you have to repent. Repent of them. Repent of your sins. Repent because Jesus is coming. Amen. I don't want to be outside the walls. I don't want God to call me a dog, just like he did at verse 15. Outside is all the dogs. I don't want to be a dog. I want to be the one who said, I've seen the heaven and I'm going to be in hell. No, I don't want God to say, you're a dog. Go outside the gate. Go burn in the sulfur fire. No. You don't want God to call you a dog each time you come to church. You hear the word of God and yes, you reject it. No. You need to get your life straight. Amen? Mm-hmm. You don't want to be outside the gates no more. Everyone who loves everything. One who loves and does what is false. There's so many things that's going on right now in America that's contrary to the word of God. Everything. There's this guy right now who's petitioning the courts to see if he could marry his second wife legally. He married his second wife through a religious ceremony. I don't know how that's possible, but they believe in that. So now he said, well, if the lesbian and the homosexuals got their way to marry by the courts, so I should get my way to marry my second, my third, my fourth wife. So they petitioned that. They said it's love. They're keeping me from loving more. They're practicing what the Bible says is false. They love so much. Call down on your loving. It's God is love. And at the end, he's going to show you how much love he has for you for all the sins that you have committed. Okay? So I suggest, don't live a godly life. The Holy Spirit and the bride say, come. The Holy Spirit and the bride say, come. Let those who hear say, come. Anyone who is thirsty should come. Anyone who wants to take the free gift of the word of life should come at verse 17. Come. If you're tired, come. If you want to go to heaven, come. If you want to, if you don't want to be burned through the second death, come. If you don't want God to call you a dog at the end, come. If you don't want to stay away from, if you want to live inside that city gates where the city is made out of all those gems, and the doors are made with pearls. Come. If you are tired of the life that you are living and you say, I don't know when I'm gonna die, come. Come because while the door is still open, the door of God is still open while you are still breathing. The door of God is still open while Jesus is still in heaven. But you don't know when Jesus is gonna come and you don't know when you're gonna die. So now is the time to come. You don't know. You don't know. You could be walking right now and fell outside, babe, you died. You don't know. You don't know. Come. If you're tired and you want to live that good life, come. I am warning anyone who hear the words of the prophecy of this book. If you do anything to them, God will add to you the plagues told about in this book. If you take any words away from this book of prophecy, God will take away from your share in the tree of life. That's why I said, if I'm speaking, I want to speak directly from the Bible. I want my share. I want my full share. I'm greedy. I want my full share. You know what I mean? After you've been working for God all these years, just like this song said, I've been working for God all these years. I've been coming to church all these years. I've been singing all these songs all these years. I want my full share. So therefore, I'm not going to take away and I'm not going to add nothing to it. Amen? Mm-hmm. God will take away from your share in the tree of life. He will also take away your place in the holy city. I want my crown. I want to be a manager of it. I don't want to be a servant. You know what I mean? I want to live. And that, even though we're going to be in heaven, that's mentioned everywhere, but I want to be the top mention. I want to live in a shack in heaven. I still want to go to heaven, though, but I want that top mention. So I want to make sure my words come from the Bible. Amen? Mm-hmm. So speak the truth. Amen? This book tells about these things. He who give witness to those things say yes. If you witness to hearing the word of God, say yes. Amen? Yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. Come. If you are waiting for Jesus to come into your life, come. If you know Jesus is coming, say yes, he is coming. May the grace of God, Jesus, be with God's people. May the grace of God be with you. So you could know the truth. So you could know to repent. So you could know to get your life in order. So you could know that Jesus is coming. Because like it or not, you will be judged by what you do. You will be judged by how you conduct yourself. You will be judged by everything you say. Amen. I want God to wipe away my tears. I want to live in a place where there's no more sickness, where my feet is not swollen up the minute I woke up and start doing something. My feet is swollen up. I want to live in a place where my back is not hurting me no more. I want to live in a place where I'm not feeling sad and going through depression all the time. I want to be in a place where I feel joy and happiness all the time. I want to be in a place where there's happiness and I could have fresh fruits every day. Amen? I want to be in a place where there's no more crying. Mm-hmm. He will wipe away every tears from your eyes. There will be no more death or sadness. There will be no more crying or pain. There are no, and things are no longer the way they used to be. Amen? Mm-hmm. He who was sitting on the throne, who was sitting on the throne, right? Jesus, God. He was sitting on the throne, making everything new. Then he said, write this down. You can trust these words. They are true. Amen? Mm-hmm. So obviously, it's time for you to realize. It's time for you to realize God is coming. It doesn't cost you anything, just like he said on verse 6. Amen? He said, anyone who is thirsty may drink from the spring of the water of life. It doesn't cost anything. He didn't say it. He shouted, it doesn't cost anything. Those who overcome will receive all these things from me. I will be their God, and they will be my children. He called you his children. He didn't call you his dog. He didn't call you the dogs who be outside, the worthless, the one who rejected my words, the ones who believe false things about God, the one who believe their own interpretation of what the Bible said, the one who said, well, the Bible is just a book, the ones who said, well, the heaven is not for real. He said, you will be his children. His children will be able to enter into heaven. So I suggest you live a godly life. Because I don't want you to have the second death. I want you to be as though you was going into your wedding day. I want you to feel so important, dressing all in white, ready to see your groom, ready to see your bride. I want you to say, hey, I'm going to see Jesus. Did you realize each time that you repent of your sins, it's just like you go in, you have a relationship with Christ. It's like you win when you genuinely repent. When you genuinely say, Jesus, I'm sorry for my sin. It's like you saying to God, you know, oh, you are my husband, you are my wife. I'm ready to have that relationship with you. I'm ready to commit to you. I'm giving my life to you till death do us part. But Jesus said, even to death, I'm with you. Right? Because once you accept Jesus, once you repent of your sins, once you say, I'm sorry for that, it's like you are having that bride and groom relationship with him again. It's like you becoming one with him again. There's nothing that's holding you, that's holding you apart from him. But when you hold on to that grudge, when you say, I'm not gonna forgive, when you say, I'm not gonna repent, when you say, I'd rather live in that sin, I'd rather commit adultery, I'd rather start lying, I'd rather be a lesbian, I'd rather be a homosexual, because I got love for Jesus, his love. Those people who say those things, those who practice sexual immorality will not be going to heaven. Those who practice fornication will not be going to heaven. It's not my word, it's the word of God. He's saying right here, Revelation 21 and 22. Those who practice sexual immorality won't be going. Those who lie won't be going. Those who murder won't be going. I suggest you repent and be one of those ex-lesbian. I give myself to Christ. I suggest you be an ex-murderer. I suggest you be an ex-liar. I suggest you be an ex-homosexual. Until you repent and say, I'm sorry for my sin, God. I know I lied. I know I'm wrong. I know I'm no good, but God, take me. Take me, and God will be there with you. God will forgive you. Amen? Because that's the only way you're going to be going to heaven. Amen? That's the only way you're going to say, I give myself to Jesus. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Amen. You have to give yourself to Jesus so he could use you. Because you don't want to experience that second death. In verse 8, you don't want to experience that. You don't want to experience that. I want to go to heaven.
Amen.
And we're all working to get to one place, and that's heaven. It's up to you. to decide right now, this moment, if you're going to accept God, if you're going to repent, if you're going to stop your ways. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, we have service on Wednesday. Come to Bible study on Wednesday. It is good. It is good. We're still on Leviticus 27. Leviticus 27. We're going to go through the second part of it on Wednesday. We did the first part. Leviticus 27. We're going to continue to it. So come in and worship and learn the word of God with us. And that's the last book on Leviticus. Then we're going to go straight into the next book. And we're going to continue on to that.
Leviticus Numbers. Then you said the next book?
No, yeah, we're going to go through that. And then we're going to enjoy ourselves. We're going to enjoy ourselves. We're going to have, you know, Bible study is the time to come, ask questions, learn the word of God. We learn the blessing and the cursing of God. And we learn how we to live a godly life. Because I love the book of Leviticus. It tells you exactly what God expects of you. What God expects of your life. It's a book of laws, right? The law of God. The first five books, you know, right? It's the law of God. So come and learn about the law of God. Come learn what God expects of you. So when you stand in front of Him, you be saying, well, nobody told me that. I didn't know that. If I knew it, I wouldn't have back and said, you did know it because she said on today's the 5th? July 5th, she said, well, come to Bible study. We're going through the laws of God. We're learning the laws. We're learning why it's expected of you. So when you do something, well, you know what consequence is going to come. Amen? So it's a good book. Come worship and know it. Okay? Any more announcement? We went to see the firework yesterday. You missed it.
I see.
Okay. We had a good time. Me and Pops and the kids went to a lake, Towasaki. I saw all the little ducks and geese walking inside the gate, inside there. Christina said she saw an alligator. I didn't see no alligator. She said she saw one.
Probably is like that.
She probably is up there. And all those people on the boat having a good time, families coming there with their children. It was good to get out the house, because I'm always inside my house 24/7.
Yeah.
It was a chance to get out the house and get out of this neighborhood for a few hours.
Yeah, I worked out here late at night.
I was outside till 2 o'clock. I was watching the fireworks too.
I was trying to go sleep.
Somebody had some good money to spend last night, because there she was blowing up somebody last night in this area.
Yeah, there's some money for money.
There she did find some money. So we had a good time. Also, let's bow our head as we pray and say grace so we could go home and be with our family, do what we need to do, relax. Lord, I thank you and I glorify you and I give you the glory for being God all by yourself, for always protecting us, for our coming in and coming out. Throughout the week, you helped us. I want to thank you, Lord, for giving the money to fix part of my roof that was leaking and bless me. The stump who fixed my roof for me. Bless Brother Ferguson, who always there faithfully seeking you and faithfully serving you and faithfully doing everything to please your house, oh Lord. Thank you, God. Give him an extra portion of blessing, oh Lord, for taking care of your temple, oh Lord, to taking care of the church, to be able to make this for the church, Lord. Give him the grace, give him happiness, give him love, give him a peace of mind to know that you are always there with him, you're always there watching him, you're always there, love him and give him assurance, oh Lord, hallelujah, Father, that he is sick, if, oh Lord, in any part of that body, oh Lord, that is sick, oh Lord, heal them in Jesus' mighty name, Father, right? Bless Christina and David, oh Lord, who's here, bless them, watch over them. Let them know that you are God and to always tell the truth, oh Lord, because liars don't go to heaven, Lord. Let them know at their age, Lord. Lord, kids will lie. Kids will say things that are untrue. Kids will do a lot of stuff just to see how far they will go. But God Almighty, oh Lord of Lords, I may not be able to see everything. Others may not be able to see everything, but you are able to see everything, and you know all truth. Amen. Oh God Almighty, bless them and keep them safe, oh Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, Lord. Bless this church, oh Lord. Bless this ministry, oh Lord. Bless this building. Bless everyone who come into it. Hallelujah, Father. Bless the ground, oh Lord. Bless the van, oh Lord, that we are driving to pick people up, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Oh God Almighty, in Jesus' name, bless everything we do. Bless our coming in and coming out. Bless Brother Curtis, Lord, who didn't come to church. Bless his cousins who are living with him. Bless those in our community, oh Lord, who are seeking refuge and seeking help, oh Lord. Bless those who don't have no place to stay. Bless those who are moving from their home because of no money, oh Lord. Bless them, oh Lord, who need help, oh Lord, Father Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we praise you and we glorify you, oh Lord. Amen, 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 amen. Let the word of my mouth, meditation of my heart, Father, be acceptable in our sight, Lord Jesus. In God's mighty name, we praise you. In God's mighty name, we glorify you. In Jesus' holy name, amen, amen, amen.
All right.
Amen.